the disappearance happened recently of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj. Actually, this year 2020, it is not good for the whole world. It's not suiting at all. Whole world is suffering in many ways. All sectors, economically, business-wise, political, many ways suffering. But ISKCON people, they are chanting Hare Krishna, happy they are, but they got a big blow. Departure of Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj is such a loss, I don't think we can fulfill it, we can fill up it again. Because Bhakti Charu Maharaj already, our Sankarsana Prabhu, he told, and everybody will know how Bhakti Charu Maharaj came in late in this moment, but very fast he got this super most opportunity as a personal servant to Prabhupada. It seems that the relation between Prabhupada and Bhakti Charu Maharaj was not in this birth. Many, many births, previous births, they had a relation. Many, many. By fast meeting, they could recognize each other. Oh, he is... It was said that Prabhupada, when he found out that he is a very cultured, highly educated, very perfect gentleman and from Calcutta. Prabhupada is a Calcutta boy, and he found out another Calcutta boy is well educated and very cultured, aristocratic family. He became really happy. And he was so humble and surrendered that Prabhupada became really overwhelmed, and he gave him the first assignment translating his books. First he said small books, and Prabhupada himself was proofreading his translation. Just imagine, nowadays many translators' books, few will, they will do then correction, proofreading. But for Bhakti Charu Maharaj translation, the proofreader was no other than His Divine Grace Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So that makes more close, because he got opportunity, he has to check my translation, so nobody can stop him. He can go directly to meet Prabhupada to show his translation work. So, and Prabhupada figure out that he is a qualified person, he can do the job. And he told him that he should translate all my books into Bengali language. And Bhakti Charu Swami, he took that order so seriously. Whenever, actually daytime he was busy in serving, he used to translate in night time. Almost every day, he will get up in midnight and do his translation work. Until he finished all the books to translate into Bengali language. And then in 96, he offered to Prabhupada a series, Abhay Charan, a serial. And then he thought that, I don't have a center, I have to make a beautiful temple, offered to Prabhupada. and he took that project. And when he was searching where to do it, he came to Madhya Pradesh. He was such a mesmerizing personality. Anybody will come in contact with him, see him, he will be attracted. And at that time, the chief minister of Madhya Pradesh, he was so attracted and moved by his dealings that he personally traveled with Bhaktisar Swami to few places in a helicopter to show him few places in MP, and he was promising that if the chief minister, if he want to help, I want to give so many acres of land for this project, that project. Somehow or other, Maharaj selected Ujjain. Though he have seen many few other places in Jabalpur site and the other sites, selected, and they promised to give him few hundred acres of land. But somehow or other, the government changed and things happened. It didn't work out. But still, as per the promise from his side, Bhaktisar Swami, he complete the whole temple, totally crystal white marble temple, 3 altar, 4 altar, 1 altar after previously, 3 altar, guest house, restaurant, promissory house, everything, park, everything, within 10 months, within 8 to 10 months, not even a year, installation ceremony happened, temple opening. It's a wonder. Never ever so fast any temple opened. Such a beautiful, gorgeous temple. In 2012, in his Vyas Puja offering, he wrote to Prabhupada, "Prabhupada, whatever assignment you had given to me, it's almost done. So I want to go back to you. Please call me back. You have already called few of your child, so please call me back." And he was very much eager to go and serve Prabhupada, to join him where he is. He was not interested more here. It is in 2012, 8 years back. And after 8 years, his application got sanctioned and he went. In his pranam mantra, they used to say, Maharaji, Prabhupada gata prana, isn't it? This is fact. In most of the cases, we can see Bhaktisar Swami will consider Prabhupada more than Krishna. He says, Krishna, forget. I don't want to go to Golok Vrindavan, to Krishna Loka. I forget. I'm not interested in serving Krishna. Much more interested in serving Prabhupada. So much so that he dedicated his Vyas Puja day, 17th September, that was his birthday, near about Radhashtami. But he didn't do according to Tithi, Janma Tithi. Everybody used to perform according to Tithi. He will not perform according to Tithi. Why? Because September 17th is a day, that day Prabhupada appeared in US, first time. So the appearance of Prabhupada in America, so he dedicated his birthday as a Prabhupada memorial day. Each year, in Vyas Puja day, he said, no, he was not interested to perform his Vyas Puja. Rather, he will hold a Prabhupada memorial day. Evening time, some disciples will do, but mostly the whole day activities will be as a Prabhupada memorial day. Whenever Maharaj will take any class, any instructions, Even in initiation time also, in our ISKCON tradition, that initiation time they will ask for you taking the four vows of regularity principle, isn't it? This is customary in our society. But Bhaktisharu Maharaj will add another vow, fifth vow. He said, that's a light to abstain from four regularity principle. But one more vow extra, what? No matter whatever happen, don't leave ISKCON. In initiation time, you have to take that vow too. Give that promise to me. No matter whatever happen, never ever leave ISKCON. Almost all of his disciples, he will get a promise from them. Don't leave ISKCON. Why? Now ISKCON is Prabhupada's body. ISKCON and Prabhupada is not different. He used to say, if something happened that I may go out of ISKCON, but you should not leave ISKCON. He used to go that extent. Sankarsana Nityapa was mentioning how Bhaktisharu Maharaj joined quite late in early 76. He was from a very aristocratic family. At that time, India and Bangladesh was one. In 1945, he appeared in Bangladesh. Then he, because he was a very wealthy family, so they had a house in Calcutta. So he came to Calcutta, and in his childhood education and everything was happened in Calcutta only. Then for higher education, after school education, for college education, he went to German for higher studies to do his graduation in chemistry. Prabhupada was a chemist. And he went to do his graduation in chemistry in German, in Hamburg city. At that time, just remember, in 50s, 60s, going to German from India, for us at least, I am thinking, we have not seen aeroplane. We have not seen, we heard that some Udaja, something like that. That was the time. And he went to German. But he was, I told you, no, from his previous, many previous births, he was connected spiritually and connected with Prabhupada. So he was not interested in this material education. So he came back searching spiritual life. He came all the way to Delhi, went to Rishikesh and went to Himalaya to search for some Baba or something to spiritual life. And he went somewhere in Himalaya, here and there, and saw many Baba with Ganja and all that. So he was not satisfied, he came back, went to Calcutta. There he, I don't know exactly, maybe Santadhanna Prabhu, he met past, and he got the Nectar of Devotion book. Sarvabhauma Prabhu. Sarvabhauma in Calcutta or Germany? Yes, somebody said Santadhanna, somebody Sarvabhauma. Anyway, so he got that book. And then he went to Calcutta. And somehow or other he was so curious to meet Srila Prabhupada. And then he heard that Prabhupada is coming to Kumbh Mela. Kumbh Mela happened in Allahabad in January. So he came to meet in January in Kumbh Mela. This was quite new. At that time, his name was Khirchura Gopinath.
His name
किशोर रियली इज फर्स्ट इंसेशन इज किशोर गोपनाथ देन थर्ड इंसेशन इज भक्ति चरण स्वामी या 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 अच्छा दैट सम से हाउ किशोर कुमार किशोर कुमार यस किशोर दास किशोर दास सो एंड आज प्रभु जी आर सेइंग इन कुंभ मेला ही कुड नॉट गेट दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मीट प्रभुपाद बट व्हेन ही वाज प्रभुपाद वाज कमिंग बैक टू कलकत्ता इन ट्रेन ही गॉट द अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड दैट्स इट Then Prabhupada never left him till last end. Today Govinda Maharaj was telling that he saw Bhakti Charu Swami first time. He knows him before, but he saw when Prabhupada come back from Rishikesh because they went. Bhakti Charu Maharaj went with them. Tamal Krishna Maharaj, Govinda Prabhu, they went to Rishikesh. For his health reason, but one time because of storm, Prabhupada felt very weak. And midnight, he woke up. Bhakti Charu Swami said, "Call everybody. Now time has come to leave my body. So take me to Vrindavan. I want to go to Vrindavan. Or some other, they make arrangement overnight. And they come back. And he was taking treatment with Banwali Kamiraj and Prabhupada." Get cured and he was a bit okay and then he again desired to go to west for preaching. Though everybody was saying no, Prabhupada, nobody can say no to Prabhupada. So Prabhupada went and Prabhupada was very much wanted that Bhakti Charu Swami should travel with him. But at that time he is Some happened to his passports thing, I don't know, But he went to German before, he must have passport, but he didn't get visa or something happened, he could not travel with him. So, Prabhupada went and almost night, 2 a.m. in morning. And next day, Govinda Maharaj was saying, he came to Prabhupada's house. And he was thinking, now Prabhupada is not there. His kitchen is okay, no cooking. I want to clean the Prabhupada kitchen. So to clean Prabhupada kitchen, Bibi Govinda Swami wants to clean. So he went to kitchen, Prabhupada kitchen. So he saw there Bhakti Charu Swami sitting there in the kitchen. And crying, profusely crying. Then at that time Govinda Maharaj was Ajodhyapati Prabhu. He asked him, Swamiji, what happened? Why are you crying? So he said, I'm crying because I'm not that fortunate enough to serve Prabhupada. I could not travel with him due to some reason. So he was telling that he can make out that Bhakti Charu Swami was so much eager to serve Prabhupada that he was feeling so unhappy. He was crying profusely. So he was saying, so this is a sign of how seriously he wants to serve Prabhupada. And he was mentioning that in our scripture, Rupa Goswami in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu mentioned, spiritual life begins with Guru Pada Asraya. Adav Guru Pada Asraya. Then Sikhya, Saddharma Pricha, Visrambena Guru Seva. These are the process. Then how Bhakti Charu Maharaj was a living example of it. He met Prabhupada Radharma within 10 days he got first and second initiation. And within 90 days he got his third initiation. Sannyasikya. And then Prabhupada gave him all books he was translating. And he was so much eager to serve Prabhupada. So much so that he wants to submit his whole life, his whole energy, everything for serving Prabhupada. That was his mood. By seeing that, Prabhupada was so happy. So even this time, before going to America, he was in Ujjain in the lockdown period, and he was giving almost every day classes, sometimes in Bengali, sometimes English, online classes and all that. I don't know what makes him think that he wants to go to America, I don't know. Some reason must be there. I heard one time he was speaking before going to America that Prabhupada never encouraged us to go to Vrindavan, stay Vrindavan, stay Varsana, stay this, that, no. Our preaching movement, we are all preachers. Though I know some problem is there in America, some coronavirus is going on, but as a leader, how can I stay back here? They are fighting, I will be here. He was telling like that, knowingly that America, this virus is spreading like anything, and it's very dangerous. Lockdown period is going on. Still, fearlessly, he took the decision to go to America. And even at that time, flight was to America was not easy to get. He went all the way, Nasik, Mumbai, Nagpur. Somehow he got and went to America. 16 hours flight. And there also he gave one class. And I heard that he got infected in plane only. Or somebody says in Mumbai or Nagpur, at that time there, everywhere is infection going on. Somebody said he infected in plane only, and he got high fever and throat infection when he arrived there. And you must have heard that last lecture in 6th of June in Florida. He was speaking to some students' congregation, I think. And for more than 1 hour lecture, that was his, I think, last lecture. And he was explaining the final pastimes of Prabhupada, how he was there with Prabhupada. He started how he met, he went to Mumbai, and from Mumbai how Prabhupada came to Rishikesh, he was with them, and what happened, how Rishikesh came back, all this till the end of Prabhupada's samadhi, he was explaining. And the whole pastime in the lecture he was telling. It seems that he was knowingly, he almost getting ready, I want to go. That's again and again he was describing this. Now question comes, why Prabhupada? He only told that Prabhupada said, now time has come to leave my body, take me to Vrindavan. And he was a staunch follower of Prabhupada's teaching too. So he would have come to Vrindavan. Why he went to US? If this time is leave body, then better to come to Vrindavan. Prabhupada personally did that, and he told him also. He first told to Bhaktisvara Swami, said, please take me to Vrindavan. I want to leave my body in Vrindavan. And he is a staunch follower of Prabhupada. And why he is thinking to go to America? Today, Bhumipati Prabhu, he was telling that Prabhupada used to say in Bengali, that India is my motherland, but America is my fatherland. And how come you are saying fatherland? Well, father is giving resource, money, because all my ISKCON is generated from America, all the funds, everything I got from America only. Man and money is from America. Otherwise, the ISKCON has no value. Everything I got from there, man from America, money from America. I told them distribute books, they distribute double it, more, more. Whatever I told, they do, and they give all support for my society. So everything I got from America. So that's my father's land. Bhumipati Bharat Prabhu was telling in Prabhupada's final pastime, he used to talk to some of Bengali, his godbrothers in Bengali language. He used to tell them that how he got all success from America, all support from America. That's why America is my father's land. And Bhaktisvara Maharaj was present there. And he knew that America is so dear to Prabhupada, is his fatherland. And he was so humble that Prabhupada is an elevated personality. He could leave his body in Vrindavan. But who am I? I am not of that level. So I can, as a man of ISKCON, ISKCON is Prabhupada's creation. So ISKCON generated from US, America. And that's why Prabhupada considered America as his father's land. So better I should go there. And he went there. We are thinking anyway, in each scripture it is said that Krishna will fulfill the desire of a pure devotee, a surrendered devotee. So, and all devotees, they know that Prabhupada used to say always, bhajan karo, sadhan karo, morte janle hoy. If you don't know how to die, the art of dying, then all your so-called study, practice, bhajan is useless. It's good for nothing. This is final exam. Final exam is death. If you can't make it, then that's it. What the use of so much coaching and preparation if final exam is useless? So Ante Narayana Smriti, what is the success of final exam? If you can remember Lord. Remembrance of Lord, that's it. Anta kaale chamam eva smaran uktva kalevaram. When you are living your body, uktva kalevaram, smaran, if somebody can do Krishna smaran, Krishna smriti, Ante Narayana smriti, that is the success of human life. That is the success of human life. All Santa Mahanta scripture, everybody they used to say that. That's it. No matter whatever you do in your whole lifetime, if somehow or other at the final time, death time, if you remember Lord, then that's it. That's it. So, in the case of our Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj, it is quite natural for everybody, even a topmost Nastic, non-believer of God, if a drastic situation is coming, just like a death situation in front, then he will definitely, forcibly remember Lord, isn't it? So Maharaj was proved positive COVID, they took him to hospital, and still he was not ready to accept ventilator, though he was feeling problem in breathing. So then devotee talked, the Maharaj is not agreeing to go through ventilator. And they talked to all big, big ISKCON leaders, his godbrothers, senior godbrothers. says Sapurvam. Many others, they called him, "Maharaj, please accept." And later, so when all so many senior devotees, so then Maharaj agreed, okay. Why he was not accepting ventilator? Ventilator means it is not easy thing. They'll put the pipe through your nose inside. Very irritating, very uncomfortable. And for that they will make your body unconscious. So that you should not feel that heavy pain. So Maharaj didn't want to do that, but somehow the, and when he was, it was decided that he has to go through the ventilator, they have to put the pipe inside and they will torture his body. Just imagine, any of us, anybody, any layman, he will pray to Krishna intensely, as intense as possible. Because who knows what will happen? He can't say anything. And he is going practically for that situation. That means you just imagine, if any of us will tell us that now, within 1 hour, you are going through, they will put this, that, ventilator process. If somebody will explain us, then our Narayana Smriti will happen. Yes. Parikshit Maharaj got death notice a week before. And he prepared, you know, whole Bhagavatam things, all that happened. Went to. So, similar case when going through ventilator means it is not that easy. So, mentally when he was preparing, he must drop. It is natural for everybody, as intense as possible, he will remember Lord and pray to Lord. Then he went through the ventilator when he is almost remained unconscious for a week together, for at least 10 days or 15 days or so. In the last 10-15 days, whatever he was praying, in the whole world, whatever number of devotees, everybody was praying intensely. So many Narasimha Jagya, this Jagya, that Jagya, puja, whatever, all the devotees for that 2 weeks, isn't it? 10-15 days, everybody was praying for Maharaj. So he was not praying to Krishna. He forced all the devotees in ISKCON society to pray to Krishna. So it is not only one smarana of Krishna. Lakhs and lakhs of devotees, whatever possible way, they pray to Krishna. And finally, he chose, actually in America that day was 5th or 4th? 4th. But somebody said that's Guru Purnima day. There Guru Purnima is 4th, okay. So the Guru Purnima day, Sanatana Goswami's disappearance day. Sanatana Goswami's deity is Madan Mohan. And he established his deity in Ujjain, in his project in Madan Mohan also. And that was the day of Sanatana Goswami, that Purnima day. So he chose that day. So, actually Sanatana Goswami, because of that we are not telling Guru Purnima. Sanatana Goswami case is Mudiya Purnima. The Guru Purnima is because that is the appearance of Vyasadev. Disappearance of Sanatana Goswami, but appearance of Vyasadev. Vyasadev, all the gurus are representative of Vyasadev. That's why it's called Vyasa Purnima or Guru Purnima. Except ISKCON and Gaudiya Math, rest all organizations, spiritual organizations at least, everybody they observed Guru Puja in that particular day. All their respective gurus and acharyas they worship. Even it is mentioned in Chaitanya Bhagavat that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he performed Nityananda Prabhu Vyasa Puja, Vyasa Punima day. He was observing Vyasa Puja, Vyasa Punima day. And so that Vyasa Purnima, Guru Purnima day and Sanatana Goswami's day, so he took the blessings of his worshipable deity Madan Mohan, Sanatana Goswami's deity Madan Mohan, and Sanatana Goswami's blessings, Vyasadeva's blessings, blessings because Guru Purnima means all the spiritual, all the gurus, they used to bless their disciples that day. A special blessings day. He took all their blessings to be at the lotus feet of his eternal guru, Srila Prabhupada. That was his only desire, to attain Prabhupada's lotus feet and serve him eternally. And in Guru Purnima day, in ISKCON, we used to speak about Sanatana Goswami, because that's Sanatana Goswami's disappearance day. All classes, everything about Sanatana Goswami. Nobody will discuss Vyasadev, mostly Sanatana Goswami, Mudiya Purnima and all that. But from this Guru Purnima onwards, Maharaj forced everybody in ISKCON, they have to discuss about him as a guru. We have to now remember him in that day. So now Maharaj, why everybody is touched by Maharaj? Each and every, not only devotee, those who are outsider also, any person come in contact with Maharaj somehow or other, once or twice or for some hours, for one day, Maharaj was mesmerizing personality. Everybody will get attracted by his personality. His very, very sweet behavior, his dealings, his talkings are so sweet. His singings was nectarian, so melodious, and dealings, his cookings, everything is sweet, so caring, so compassion, full of compassion, so personal. That's why he touched everybody through his dealings and personality. He was not only a good person with caring personality, he was a wonderful leader, a neta. His leadership, though he was the junior most Prabhupada disciple, but he was so lovable among everybody, so appreciated by everybody, that he became GBC chairman, the topmost authority of ISKCON. He became twice he became GBC chairman. It is not ordinary responsibility, such a high responsibility. Already he was GBC and guru and many other leading responsibility. On the top of that, he used to handle GBC chairman for 2 times. And he attracted people from very simple village of Bangladesh to British Council. From smallest to the toughest. And because he was a wonderful leader, through his instructions, through his capability, ability, he sorted out many problems Once he also started a program to go to all old Prabhupada disciples to bring them back. That was his plan. Those who are left out, somehow or other frustrated, pride, he said, no, they should come back. He was so friendly and he used to go to them, and by his sweet dealings, they will come back. Many of them, they come back. And anybody will deal with him for some time, he will definitely get touched. Today, one devotee was telling that once in Ujjain, the commissioner, high commissioner, from MP, he was coming, and around 8 in the district, DM, district magistrate, 8 district magistrates were accompanied with that commissioner, and few SP, SSP, the high government officer with all his staffs and all his staffs was coming. And in Ujjain at that time, Maharaj Vyas Puja, just 2 days after, many international devotees, they came and they were leaving. So Maharaj was sitting, so everybody was coming and paying their obeisances and going, leaving to their country. And this high personality government officer, commissioner, so he had darshan. He was not offering obeisances to Prabhupada, not to DT. He was adamant, you know, very high officer. So finally, they brought him to Maharaj's room. And he went also, high respected officer, he went, Maharaj, sit down. But because all the devotees are leaving, so they were just coming and offering obeisances and going. They're coming, and that commissioner, and 8 district magistrates were sir sitting outside. And how can he tolerate that in front of him, a Babaji, everybody is coming and paying dandavat pranam, he has not seen his lifetime. That kind of, you are saying dandavatik, what they are doing? Totally slipping down and like that. You are thinking, what is going on? Offering obeisances, respect, not considering me anything. You are sitting next to Maharaj, nobody is talking to him, sing to him, everybody is offering obeisances to Maharaj and going. For half an hour, he became until then Maharaj told his servants, stop everybody to come. So they said, just close the door. And Maharaj talked to him for half an hour. After half an hour, when he was taking leave, he paid full prostrated obeisance to Maharaj. He didn't pay to DT in temple. Now, after half an hour, he paid his full obeisances, and all the gunmen and the SPs and the DMs, they also pay obeisances to Maharaj. That was Maharaj's power. That was his attraction. It touched their heart. So, that's why he, thousands and thousands of followers, Maharaj had. Just by one smile, just by one sentence of word, a few words, he will win the heart of a person. It was so sweet, so enchanting. So, it's very, very rare to find such person. But the best among all qualities in Maharaj, the best of the best qualities, that his high regard and total surrender and dedication to the feet of his beloved spiritual master. This is revealed in the scripture, in the all revealed scripture. Jasya deve parabhakti jatha deve tatha guru. If somebody has unflinching faith at the feet of Krishna and the similar faith at the feet of Guru, then all the purport of Vedic knowledge will manifest in the channel. And here Maharaj was a living example of that kind of person. He was so much dedicated for Prabhupada. In every talking, every class, every discussion, every katha, and always, anytime, he will bring Prabhupada. Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada is his everything. Just Prabhupada conscious, so much so Prabhupada conscious, so much. So, there are two kinds of Bhagavat. One Bhagavat is a Bhakti Rasa Shastra. Another Bhagavat is a Bhakti Rasa Patra. So, he is kind of Bhakti Rasa Patra. Though he went to his desired planet where Prabhupada is there to serve him, but still for us is a great loss. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Ramananda Rai, Dukha Madhye Kona Dukha Gani Guru Tara, that is the highest distress, Ramananda Rai told, Krishna Bhakta Virha Vina Nahi Dukhara. When we miss the association of such exalted devotee, then no more distress can compare to that. So in both the case, such a caliber of preacher and devotee like Maharaj is staying in the planet, is that glorious, is going also that glorious. So for him it is same, whatever he is busy in his job. But for us, we lost a jewel. So with this kind of our offerings from our feelings, from our heart, I want to offer respect, pranam and sandhanjali from my core of my heart at the lotus feet of Sri Srimad Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj, that if he could have, out of his mercy, out of his compassion, give it just a minute drop of dedication what he has for his spiritual master, then our life will be success. Sri Bhakticharya Swami Maharaj ki, Samveta Bhakta Vrinda ki, Jai.